all big Tesla news for the week ending December 18th, 2020. Welcome to my Tesla weekend. Tesla stock started the week at 618, and we knew it would be a wild ride, and boy did Mr. Toad deliver as the stock finished up over 12% on the week. Compared to NASDAQ, which also had a pretty good week, finishing out up 2%, and the Dow Jones Industrial Average, which is up 0.5%. In delivery news, Tesla Model 3 extends its lead in December 2020 with year-to-date EV registrations in the Netherlands. While this isn't surprising, what is a pleasant surprise is to see how strong the competition is coming on. Kia Niro sold just about as many. ID3, which wasn't even available until halfway through the year, coming on quick. Kona, e-Golf, even Polestar 2 has sold 1,963 units. Not bad, guys. Not bad. Nissan Leaf, pretty disappointing considering the massive early first mover advantage they had in EVs, but, you know, what are you going to do? Tesla sells over twice as many cars as its rivals combined in Australia, says this somewhat misleading headline, which uses figures for only EVs and lifetime sales, which is, you know, not the best indicator, but still, I'll take good news where I can find it. Things are going similarly well in the UK, where ultra-low emission vehicles registered for the first time, as in electric cars mostly. Tesla is having a boffo year, more than twice as good as its nearest competitor, although this chart does end in September, while October and November were surely good months of sales for the ID3. Which leads, of course, to Tesla receives invitation to build UK GigaFactory with full cooperation of local authorities. Because, I mean, who wouldn't invite Tesla to come and build a multi-billion dollar factory? Regional leaders said they're reaching out because they're facing unexpected delays in Germany, which is not exactly true. And what could possibly go wrong? Except, you know, all of the downsides of Brexit. Elon Musk Boring Company buys industrial site near Tesla's under-construction Texas factory. It's a pretty cool thing. They're going to be moving the headquarters of the Boring Company to a suburb of Austin. If we take a look, this is the actual building itself, 15709 Impact Way, up of Pflugerville, Texas. Let's see how close Pflugerville is. Here is the GigaFactory Texas site. Giga Texas, right here, right next to the Austin Bergstrom International Airport, where Elon typically lands his jet, and just a paltry 17 minutes away. Here it is. What's interesting about Pflugerville is they have this lovely executive airport. Interesting. Although I don't think it's that interesting, maybe it doesn't mean anything, but let's take a look. Oh, look at that. That place is fancy. It's got a 6,000-foot paved runway, ideal for corporate jets. But, as we know, Elon flies almost exclusively into the Austin Bergstrom International Airport, except on November 1st, when Elon Musk and SpaceX's jet Twitter account noted he flew into Pflugerville. So Elon's been there, so I don't know, man. I think this is probably a better runway for someone who flies in and out regularly, not having to contend with commercial traffic, which presumably takes priority in the schedule of landing and taking off. But why are we even talking about Boring Company? Because of all the reasons, including Las Vegas approves Boring Company's loop transport system with Tesla vehicles. It looks like Tesla has gained preliminary approval to expand into this massive loop to serve the greater Las Vegas Strip area. This new transportation is going to be built around a 10-mile-long tunnel system that will go from the airport to Fremont with stops along all the major resorts along the Strip. There's a rumor floating around that Tesla has already reached their 500,000 delivery goal for the year, but I don't put that much weight into rumors. Tesla is giving a year of free supercharging to new Model 3 and Y buyers as it tries to ramp up and hit that goal. But even if they have hit that goal, why not juice the numbers a little bit more? If you think you could still take delivery before the end of the year, you could get in on this 1 year of free supercharging. Tesla tells employees Model S and X production will shut down for 18 days. Now, could this be something bigger than a simple retooling? Could this be the long-awaited refresh? Well, it's tough to say. They're going to shut it down. It's not unusual. 18 days, maybe a little longer than normal. And if we look at the email, nothing really stands out. The lines will be shut down from December 24th to January 11th. We would like you to take the opportunity to refresh or spend time with your family. Oh my goodness. Does this mean my video about the Plaid Model S being a whole new model could come true? I don't know. Link in the corner or the description. Who knows? Who knows? And if you're curious what a refreshed Model S could look like, well, look at this roadster-inspired beauty. If that is what the new Model S looks like and it performs to the specs suggested, the Porsche Taycan is gonna have some catching up to do. Quick thanks to my two new patrons, Juho Rutinen and Kirk Shalosky. You might recognize Kirk. He's always busy in the comments of all the hottest Tesla videos. So thank you to both of you for your support at the cool level. EVs could soon cost the same as gas cars thanks to lower battery costs, said anyone paying attention. The average price per kilowatt hour for batteries is expected to hit $101 in 2023, according to a report by Bloomberg NARF. So if you could hit $100 two or three years from now, although it is rumored that Tesla is already there, what would that mean? What would we do tonight? The same thing we do every night, Pinky. Try to take over the world. Toyota's chief says electric vehicles are overhyped, which is disappointing, and this is gonna age like milk. Considering their early lead with the Prius hybrid, I would have thought that Toyota would be an industry leader by now, but they just aren't. They are still pushing for hydrogen, which is a fool's errand to say the least. They only sell them in a few markets, and they've got a lot of absolutely fundamental flaws behind the technology. Specifically, we still can't deliver on the promise of hydrogen for all the reasons. The biggest one is efficiency losses leading to high costs. It ain't cost effective. You lose so much energy in the process of making and using and transporting the hydrogen, it doesn't make sense. And getting clean enough hydrogen to use is very expensive. And in most cases, it's just cheaper to use hydrocarbon byproducts from fossil fuels. It's not good. Meanwhile, batteries have continued to develop and advance at ridiculous paces. Tesla owner Silicon Valley tweeted, hashtag FSD beta handles a busy left turn like a champ. It yields to cars well, coming from both sides and then turns. To which Elon said, it will get absurdly good. Tesla AI / autopilot engineering is awesome. There's some great AI out there, but can it self-drive while playing Cyberpunk? No, and neither can Tesla's. I mean, I'm excited, don't get me wrong. And what is Elon supposed to say? Nah, it's gonna be okay, I guess. So take it with a grain of salt. Canoo unveils its new electric cargo vehicle starting at $33,000. It's a purpose-built cargo vehicle with all kinds of interesting space inside you would need for a delivery rig. And it comes in, you know, one color, I guess. And as interesting as it is, I kind of feel like the design reminds me of something. Oh, that's right. Speaking of which, we do have some Cybertruck news. The Hot Wheels version has been confirmed to be even more accurate than we ever could have imagined, specifically that it has been delayed. I mean, if that's not true to form for Tesla, what is? What's going on there, guys? Best guess I can come up with is that since the design will be slightly changed, they are also changing the design of the toy? I don't know. I didn't get one, so doesn't really affect me. Rumor, Tesla Giga Berlin will soon receive Model Y prototypes with new 4680 tabless cells and structural architecture. And you know, again, I'm not a big fan of rumors. I like things that are confirmed. Oh, look at that. Giga Berlin will be the first to use our new structural pack, 4680s, both front and rear body casting and advanced paint shop. Warning, with so much new technology, production timing is naturally harder to predict. So, yeah, I mean, I guess it's not really a rumor. This has been talked about for a while, so I guess it's good to see it confirmed. Tesla Solar is now available not merely in small, medium, and large, but also in 8 different sizes in total, ranging from 4 kilowatts to 18 kilowatts. So, you know, that's good. Tesla is upgrading Model 3 and Model Y headlights with more powerful and precise beams. Because if there's one thing you want behind you at a stoplight, it's someone with more powerful beams. Fortunately, they'll also be more precise, so, I don't know, fingers crossed. Another week, another police cruiser added somewhere in Tesla fashion, Spokane Police to add Tesla Model Y SUV to the fleet. Very exciting, they just keep adding these. That's not one, but as more departments adopt them, I believe we'll see their popularity rise as the specs speak for themselves. Tesla Model Y rear-wheel drive deliveries reportedly starting in January. This would be a slightly lower-priced option, which of course would be wonderful for a lot of consumers. But what I'm really waiting on is to see pictures of that third row. Come on, baby, don't disappoint me. And the last one, which feels like big news, Tesla muss Bauarbeiten stoppen wegen fehlender Sicherheitsleistung. Oof, that's a lot of German. 4 Wochen für 0 Euro testen? Bitte nein. Let's try this in English. Could not translate. Good job, Gargle. No matter. It says that they have until January 4th to make a $100 million deposit in the unlikely event the site needs to be returned to its original state. The project has not stopped. The project continues moving forward, and there is no material indication that the construction will need to stop. So what am I missing or misunderstanding? Leave a comment below. Set me straight. Stay tuned, stay juicy, and I can't wait to see you clever robots on the flippity-flop.